Hello, my friends. Today we are at another building that belongs to BION Terrarium Center and is called Exorancho. This complex was specially built for breeding and keeping of small mammals and big reptiles such as monitors or Rhinoceros Iguanas that are just behind me. And as you probably know, we try to do our best to try as much possible ways to keep and breed the animals with maximum productivity and maximum comfort for the animals. During this year, we have built a special enclosure for our Cyclura cornuta or Rhinoceros Iguana. This is an enclosure for our breeding stock, for actually part of our breeding stock, which consists of one male and four females. And let me show you what we have done and how the animals feel inside the new enclosure. Let's go. The enclosure is really big. It is 5 meters long, 2 meters deep, and it is quite enough for keeping of such a big breeding group. And we hope to see the first clutches in the next year, 2022 breeding season. Let's see what is inside and see what they are doing. What we have here is the several basking points. One is just behind me. The lighting is already off because it's almost evening here, but it switches on for at least 10 hours and maximum, as far as I remember, 14 hours. And the whole enclosure is covered with a thick layer of coarse sand. We have water dish inside, we have several feeding dishes. And actually it is really, really hot here inside. If we have +25, +26 degrees Celsius outside the enclosure, here it is about 28, 29 and even 30 degrees Celsius of ambient temperature. Just under the lights, it is 45, 46, 47 degrees Celsius. So it's really, really hot. Two lights give us UVB lighting, which is necessary for these animals to feel comfortable. Yeah, and we changed the interior decoration completely. We have several big and massive logs for them to feel more comfortable. They really like to hide under it. They really like to have a rest above it, and they actually like them. The humidity here is quite low, about 40%, but they experience at least 2 sessions of spraying in the evening and in the morning to keep some humidity, to help them to soak water, to help them to shed properly. And as you can hear, we have some lemurs, lemurcata, in this in this room. Yeah, and sometimes they need to communicate with each other, so we will probably skip this time for some minutes. Additionally, we have here a specially constructed nesting area where we expect our females to lay eggs. The key point, as far as we experienced from our own from our own experience and from our friends all over the world, the Cyclura cornuta needs special areas full of sand to make a really big nest and lay eggs inside it. So here we tried to make it under this log. This is a plastic bath filled with 1 ton of sand, and it is covered with a wooden plate to imitate an effect of a shelter or an effect of some secure place for a female like to stimulate her to make a nest exactly here, because we need comfortable place for her to lay eggs and for us to excavate eggs successfully and safely for her and for the eggs. So if you can see it, this is the part of our breeding group, a male, two females, third female and the fourth female. They have many options to rest, they have many options to hide, so we try to avoid unnecessary conflicts within the group, if any. They actually use the whole amount of space that is presented here, so from the upper parts, they really sometimes sit there, especially in the morning. To the hides that are situated inside the walls, so holes there, 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 under the logs again, and everywhere for them to have many options to choose to feel comfortable when they want. As you know, we are in Kyiv, Ukraine, and it is December now, and it's quite hard to maintain high temperatures in enclosures for exotic animals, for big lizards. And the key solution for such situation is such heating panels. They are quite hot, and they help us to maintain the temperature. These heating panels, they allow us to keep very high temperature that is needed for these exotic reptiles. As you can see, recently they had a meal. Their diet is quite variable. They are omnivorous, so sometimes we give them food that is rich in protein. Sometimes we give them food that is that consists of fruit and vegetable. So here we have lettuce, apples. I don't know the English variant for this fruit, unfortunately. And as you see, we dust everything with calcium powder, because they need a lot of calcium to stay healthy and strong. Yeah, and they've already finished their meal. They, of course, they chose their favorite food items and left something that they don't like very much for the rest of the time. These plates will be removed in an hour by our keepers to allow the animals to live in clean and open space.